deep, dark lies. And it starts to push you away. It pushes you in a direction that is comfortable. The mind controls everything. So what I realized was that when I was growing up and I was 300 pounds and I got all fat and I got all insecure, I realized that my mind kept taking me in this direction. When things got uncomfortable for me, when I was facing my insecurities, when I was facing my fears, my mind said, oh no, we have a tactical advantage. We need to get you, separate you from this feeling. This feeling over your life is all about feelings. You want the happy feeling. We don't want that feeling of this sucks. Why am I here? And you don't have any, so you can't answer those questions, so you leave. I started realizing that if in that moment, you can answer those questions, and you are now in charge of your brain versus your brain ruling you, that's where all that stuff comes from. So the 40% rule is all of that. You get to 40%, your brain says, we're done. Let's roll, man. This is starting to get painful. This is uncomfortable. So you sit down. You have to figure out ways. And everybody's different. That's how the book kind of talks about. Like, we all have these things about 5 steps to this and 4 steps to this. It's a lot more than that. It's a habit. So if you know that at 40%, I'm feeling pain. At 40%, I'm feeling pain. That's when the 40% rule kicks in. Now it starts. Okay, I'm feeling pain. My mind's saying, get out of here. Run. Flee. The fight or flight kicks in. Okay, we're done. We're not good enough. It starts telling you all these things. You start to believe it. Because the mind controls all. This is the time when you have to gain control back in your mind. It's okay. Let me see if I know the 45%. And once you start giving yourself more and more hope, and start realizing, okay, the mind starts to be, okay, what are you doing? We're supposed to be going right, and you're going left. You start then controlling your mind. Start finding more in yourself. And then it goes from 40% to a lot further than that. But that's the start of it, though. Get to the spot where your mind is saying stop. Wherever that is, you got to get there first. You got to control yourself in that moment. You have to have the truth to have a starting point. If I'm lying to you about who I am, there's no starting point. There's a false reality. You have to create the real reality. So for me, I was lying to this, lying about that, so I had no starting point. Once you come face to face with who you are, you have a starting point. All right, I'm not real smart. I have no courage. I have no self-esteem. I have no nothing. Nothing. That's my starting point. Now we can move from there. But if I tell myself I'm strong, I have courage, I'm smart, and all these are lies, you continuously push that starting point backwards. So that starting point is the truth that only you can tell yourself. We like to surround ourselves. It makes us feel so good. Those people who say, it's okay, it's okay, it's not okay, it isn't okay, man. And I get it, society's changing. We love to feel wanted and loved, trust me. That's all important, it is. But you have to have the truth from people. Hey, you're not working your butt off hard enough. You're not trying hard enough. We all think you're trying hard, but what are you gauging that off of? Are you gauging off of, like, I talked to this one kid the other day. Kyle is just kicking my ass. I said, what are you gauging that off of? I go, are you trying? He goes, yeah, I'm trying my ass off. I'm studying hard. I go, what are you gauging trying hard off of? Well, in high school, I didn't have to try at all, and I made great grades. In college, I'm trying hard. You're trying hard compared to what you did in high school, which was, it came easy to you. So your reality is something you created off of something easy. So you trying hard is 2 hours of study. I'm gonna tell you the difference in trying hard and trying hard. Trying hard is something in your mind just doesn't. So it's all about, you know, reality and what you're basing things off of. When I was 297 pounds, and I was fat as hell trying to be a Navy SEAL, the scariest thing in the world to me even to this day was that that could have been the rest of my life. I thought then I was trying hard. That's the scariest thing in the world. I thought then, 297 pounds, working for Ecolab, spraying for cockroaches, making $1,000 a month, I thought that was me at my 100% potential. Come to find out, a few years later, I wasn't anywhere near that. 106 pounds less, graduate Navy SEAL training, went on to do all these other things. Looking back on that, that was me trying hard. That's why people gotta understand, what is in us, we have no idea until we start trying hard.
and I mean really trying hard, when you're obsessed with, hey, this is my new norm. My new norm is that, wow, this isn't always fun. It's not always meant to be fun. And that's when you know you're trying hard. We have the easy voice telling yourself, I'm easy at 90% of my full potential, maybe 100% at that 20%. That's that voice that we all love. That's that very comfortable voice that's that mommy holding you saying, it's gonna be okay. Doesn't care how good you are, just loves you. Just loves you no matter how messed up you are in life. That's where you wanna be at. And we live over here in this land. So what you have to do first is turn up this voice over here. The voice saying things to you that aren't nice. And it's not putting yourself down. People take this the wrong way in this new society. I'm not saying to put yourself down. I'm saying listen to the truth. And the truth isn't in the 20%. The truth is in this other part of your brain saying, look, man, you're wasting a bunch of percentage here. We have 80 more percent that we're not tapping into, because in this other 80% is suffering, pain, failure, self-doubt, darkness, and then a whole bunch of light. So a lot of us know that. I can get over here, but over here, man, this is much better, because I gotta go through this journey that is not fun. This from 20 to 100% is not fun. So we decide to live over here. So everybody goes, how do you do that? You know exactly how to do that. You know exactly, it's not a magic trick. It's all back down to a very primitive mindset of we just have to do. It's like breathing. Breathing becomes normal. Like, we don't know that we're doing. That's how you have to live your life. When that alarm clock goes off at 4 or 5 in the morning, your mind says no. You just say, this is what we do. It's what we do now. Because to get to where you want to go, the amount of pain involved, I'm not saying physical, I'm not saying you got to break yourself off.
Sunga, 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 s song.
Soul of the Kutta, baby, soul of the Kutta.